Καλώς ήρθες στην Ελλάδα.
Ευχαριστώ.
Είναι μια από τις λέξεις που έχουμε χρειαστεί εδώ στην Ελλάδα. Το ευχαριστώ. Ας ξεκινήσουμε με μια τυπική ερώτηση. Steve, πότε ξεκίνησε η ιστορία του group?
I just formed a band in London in 1975. And just we used to play in the pubs in the East End of London and everything for quite a few years before we got signed in 1979. Mm-hmm. And basically from then on really we just toured the world a lot, you know, doing album tours, and we sort of broke in Europe first and then America, and we've just done loads and loads of touring, and the fans everywhere have just become more and more all the time, you know. But even from the first album, the fans were really strong for the band, you know, so it's been fantastic, really. I mean, we're still around after 12 years of being professional, and, you know, I'm glad we're still around and there's still loads of fans. I want to carry on for, you know, as long as we can, you know.
Σαν συγκρότημα, ήσασταν πολλά χρόνια χωρίς να βγάλετε δίσκο. Και βγάλετε δίσκο το 1980. Γιατί άρχισε αυτό το πράγμα?
Well, it just took a really long time to get a record deal because at the time, 75, 76, you know, the punk thing was happening. It was really difficult to get work, and we just had to keep playing, you know, as many gigs as we could, but there wasn't very many gigs about. So it took like, you know, over 4 years to get a deal, and we were just playing around the clubs and pubs all over the country. But in some ways, it was, in retrospect, it was probably a good thing because, you know, we had a lot of changes in the band, personnel and everything. And so it gave us plenty of time to get the band really solid, you know, as a unit. And also, we built up a very strong following with the fans, you know, in Britain. And so when we got signed in 1980 and made the first album, we went on tour with Judas Priest. You know, it was the first major tour we did. I think Priest were really surprised because we'd already played, you know, around the country a lot, you know, in the clubs, and we had a lot of Maiden fans at the gigs. And they were very surprised, I think, you know, the reaction that we got. So it was great, you know, it was great for us.
Πολλοί οπαδοί δικοί σας λένε ότι οι δύο πρώτοι δίσκοι που έχετε βγάλει, οι δύο πρώτοι δίσκοι των Maiden, είναι οι πιο αυθεντικοί. Άλλοι το αποδίνουν στο Diana.
Well, possibly. I think when the first two albums were the songs that were written over the four-year period that, before we were signed, pretty much. There was only two or three new songs on the second album that were written, you know, quite sort of recently when we did the album. So I think sometimes some of your best material is written over a period, you know, like a long period, whereas like when you start writing songs after that, you have to write songs maybe within just six or eight weeks. And so sometimes, you know, I mean, like the first album is almost like a best of, you know. So I think it's probably more down to the songs than necessarily Paul's voice, really. I mean, I think Paul had a really good voice, but there's no way we could have carried on with Paul because, I mean, he didn't want to do touring and that anyway, so we had to make a change. If we didn't make a change, I think that maybe the band would have split up or something, you know. I don't think that Maiden would still be here now if we'd have stayed with Paul.
Σε τι σημαίνει ο Έντι, ξεκίνησε με προορισμό και σκοπό ή τυχαία διακόσμηση τα εξώφελα των δίσκων σου?
No, it was more luck really, because in the early days we used to have a singer, before Paul, we used to have a singer called, a guy called Dennis, and he used to really like Kiss and everything, and he used to sort of put a sword through his mouth with blood capsules and all this stuff. And when he left the band, you know, it was good stage stuff, but, you know, we didn't really want to carry it on with a person in the band. So we decided to do something, you know, special, you know, with the backdrop, and we got a mould of somebody's face, like a mask, and we used to call it Eddie the Ed, you know, and we just put it up the back, and then we had the blood capsules coming out of the mask. And so really that was, you know, I mean, when we played bigger places, we had a bigger one built with smoke and eyes lit, you know, and that became Eddie the Ed, you know, that's what we used to call it. And then for the first album, it was just an extension of that, you know. So it was more luck, really, you know.
More luck.
I mean, once we had Eddie, you know, the cover, then obviously you can do lots of things with it. You know, you can market it really well. It's a good image, but it wasn't something that we said, oh, you know, we need to have this, because we already had it. You know, even when we was playing in the pubs, we had this face, this ugly face.
Πιστεύεις πως πρέπει το heavy metal να σχετίζεται με την κόλαση και τον διάβολο?
No, not really. I mean, I mean, a lot of songs get written about that sort of thing, I suppose. A lot of bands, you know, say that they're into it and all that, but I don't think so, really. I think it's probably just like an image. I mean, we're not into that stuff. I mean,
οι στίχοι σας διακρίνονται περισσότερο για την υπαρξιακά τους νοήματα, όπως το No Praying for the Dying. Και οι μελωδίες και οι ρυθμοί έχουν ένα ευρωπαϊκό ηρωισμό.
Well, the music itself is you know, very powerful music. So you, when you write lyrics, you know, you need to write something powerful or with strong feeling or atmosphere or mood or whatever. And I think quite often when most people question, you know, what's happening, you know, life after death and stuff like this. And so it's very powerful, you know, lyrics. You can really put strong mood in, you know, into the words and stuff. It's just very interesting. It's better than writing about, you know, being on the road, or, you know, it's pretty sort of boring to write about stuff like that. So it's important to have lyrics as well that mean something, you know, not just rubbish, you know.
Για μένα πιστεύω ότι εσύ δεν παίζεις heavy metal. Απλά παίζεις μια καλή ποιοτική μουσική, η οποία μουσική φέρνει εικόνες και συναισθήματα.
Thank you. Well, I think we have pretty much our own sound, you know. I think when you hear a Maiden album, it's very distinguishable, you know, sound with a lot of other bands. But I don't know really how that happened. It just evolved. The sound evolved from like just listening to lots of different bands, you know, influences of many, many bands. And so we don't sound like any one particular band, I think. I think sometimes some of the bands now, they tend to be, some of the younger bands tend to just listen to or be influenced by one or two bands, and they end up sounding a bit like those bands. I think it's far better to have many influences. Mm. Then you don't really sound like anybody, you know, you have your own sound.
Ο άλμπουμς το No Pray for the Dying, υπήρχε ένα κομμάτι μέσα. Υπήρχε το Mother Russia, το οποίο πιστεύω είναι το καλύτερο κομμάτι του δίσκου, για μένα βέβαια πάντα. Αλλά γιατί όμως προωθήσατε το Holy Smoke?
I think in retrospect, really, I think we all agreed that we should have released Tail Gunner as the first single. But at the time, when you're making an album, you have to decide very early, you know, which single you're going to go with, because you have to mix it first, and you know, in order to have a single ready for the album. So really, sometimes I think in the past we've not always chose the right single, but you don't really always have time to wait until you've mixed all the songs before you choose. So Holy Smoke, I think, worked very well because we had a funny video, you know, for it, and so it worked good for that. But really, I think when we look back, I think we would have preferred to release Tail Gunner as a first single, really. And I think it would be maybe more representative of the album.
Δώσετε τον τίτλο Mother Russia στο κομμάτι, ενώ ο ρυθμός και η αρμονία είναι καθαρά ελληνική. Και μάλιστα ο χορός λέγεται Καλαμαθιανός. Το έχετε ψάξει αυτό το θέμα καλά?
I don't know, it really... I had a piece of that music I had for some time, and I just thought that to me it sounded like Russian, you know, and so that's why I wrote, you know, I thought it had to be called Mother Russia or something to do with Russia, because it just conjured up the sound for me, sounded like it was Russian. So I don't know, maybe I should have written about I should have Alexander the Great or something.
That's it.
But you know,
Alexander the Great. So cut somewhere in time, που γράφει το κομμάτι, το Alexander the Great. Είχε καθαρά ελληνικούς ρυθμούς, ποντιακούς.
Well, really, whenever I get a piece of music that I've written, then sometimes it just, the sound of it conjures up an image, you know, for me. And that was just a very strong image to write about Alexander the Great. And same thing with Mother Russia, it just sounded Russian to me. So, I mean, in the future maybe I might have a song that might conjure up some image of India or Japan or something. The music might be, you know, it's the music that makes me want to write something about a particular country or whatever. It's just the sound of the music, you know.
Πριν ένα μήνα είχα προσκαλέσει στην Αθήνα ένα φίλο μου, τον Τζέντε Μάγια του Μάναγουα. Το ρώτησα ποια είναι η γνώμη του για σένα, γιατί καθώς είναι μπασίστας όπως και εσύ, και ποια τεχνική στον μπάσο. Εκείνο που μόνο μου απάντησε, και πιστεύω ότι δεν θα έπρεπε να το πει αυτό το πράγμα, είναι ότι έχετε καλό μάνατζερ, τίποτα άλλο.
Yeah, but Well, I mean, he's a bass player, so he probably, he has an opinion, whatever, but I mean, he's a very good bass player, so whatever, but I'm not really a fan of their music too much. Some of it's all right, but technically he's a very good bass player, but if he doesn't like my bass playing, I don't. Yeah. It doesn't really bother me.
Θέλω να σε ρωτήσω από ό,τι έμαθα βέβαια, βέβαια τίποτα δεν κρατήθηκε τυχαίο μυστικά. Πρόκειται να κυκλοφορήσει ένα καινούριο άλμπουμ, ένα καινούριο δίσκο, ο οποίος αναμένεται σύντομα. Πώς θα λέγεται, θα κυκλοφορήσει μάλλον στην Ελλάδα, αν δεν κάνω λάθος, στην Αγγλία κυκλοφόρησε. Πώς θα λέγεται ο δίσκος αυτός, τι θα έχει και πού θα διαφέρει από τον προηγούμενο.
Well, we started writing the album in September and we started recording in October. And we recorded it at a Nime studio, so we had a control room put in and everything, because we recorded the last album with the same place, but with a mobile, and this time it was with our own equipment. And we spent a bit more time on the production, you know, getting the drum sound bigger. It's a very big sound, a very heavy sound, and so I think it's the best sounding album we've had, you know. As for the songs, I think they're really strong songs, but, you know, the fans can decide, you know, when it comes out, really, you know, what they think. But it's quite a varied album, you know. There's quite a lot of different styles on the album, because of the different, you know, like four of us were writing the song, so it's quite different things happening, you know. It's a really interesting album, I think.
Έτσι, για να κλείσουμε την εκπομπή κιόλας και να μην σε κουράσουμε ξανά, θέλω να πεις έτσι ένα γνήσιο μήνυμα, ένα φιλικό μήνυμα στους Έλληνες, οι οποίοι σ' αγαπάνε πολύ πραγματικά, και αυτό το λέω ούτε για διαφημιστικούς λόγους, ούτε για τίποτα άλλο. Ποιο είναι το μήνυμά σου στον ελληνικό κόσμο, στους μεταλλάδους Έλληνες?
I'd just like to say the Greek fans will be touring in June. The album will be coming out in May, and we'll be coming to Greece in September.